For the last 30 years, I've been working within the Global Polio Eradication Initiative, particularly in close partnership with Rotary International in one of the world's largest public health programs, that is to eradicate polio. In Pakistan, as of 13 September, 18 children have been detected to be paralyzed by wild polio virus in a part of southern Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. And this compares with only one case reported in Pakistan in 2021. And this outbreak actually started after a gap of 14 months of no cases of wild polio virus detected in Pakistan. In Afghanistan, as of 13 September, two cases of wild polio virus have been detected compared with four cases last year in 2021. The large outbreak of vaccine variant polio virus that affected both countries appears to have stopped now. The last case was detected in July of 2021. The detection of children paralyzed by wild polio virus reported into Malawi and in Mozambique, and the recent detection of vaccine variant viruses in New York, in London, and in Israel, again, remind us that as long as polio virus survives anywhere, it remains a threat to children and unvaccinated persons everywhere.
Non-wild polio variants are rare forms of the polio virus that occur if the weakened strain of the polio virus contained in the oral polio vaccine circulates among under-immunized populations for a prolonged period of time. If enough children are not immunized against polio, the weakened virus can pass in the community and over time genetically revert to a form that can cause paralysis. The polio virus knows no borders. We know this well in Africa, where non-wild variants outbreaks that started in one country have quickly spread to neighboring countries, causing multiple outbreaks. Last year, the Global Polio Eradication Initiative launched an innovative tool, the novel oral polio vaccine type 2. This new vaccine is a genetically modified version of the existing monovalent oral polio vaccine type 2 that can potentially stop outbreaks of known wild polio variants. Close to 500 million doses of this new polio vaccine have been delivered in over 23 countries. With new tools and continued commitment of all stakeholders, we are confident that together we can deliver on the promise of a polio-free world, a world where no child will be paralyzed by polio ever again.
On the road to eradication and containment, surveillance will continue to play a critical role in the certification process, ensuring that poliovirus transmission has been interrupted and the hard-earned win of a polio-free world will be maintained post-certification. The Global Polio Eradication Initiative, or GPEI, relies on a highly sensitive surveillance system to determine where the poliovirus is and is not circulating, especially as we experience fewer cases of polio in fewer geographies. This global system consists of field activities to detect cases of new onset limpness or paralysis with the collection of stool specimens from patients and the collection of sewage samples known as environmental surveillance. Samples are sent to a network of 145 laboratories where technicians are trained to test and analyze polioviruses. Today, there's an increasing number of wastewater sampling sites to pinpoint where the poliovirus may be circulating, even silently, when paralytic cases are not identified. This system is how the polio program identified the recent importation of wild poliovirus into Malawi and Mozambique from Pakistan, and how we've been able to respond to outbreaks of the variant poliovirus type 2 occurring mainly in Africa, and how poliovirus was detected in Israel, London, and New York.
20 million children are walking today who would have otherwise been paralyzed if it wasn't for the global polio eradication. And this gives us 20 million reasons to go on until we succeed. So on this World Polio Day, I want to appreciate and thank all of our polio health workers, particularly those who are working in extremely difficult and often insecure conditions at the front lines. I also want to thank all of our partners, particularly Rotary International, for their support at multiple levels, from financing to advocacy for on-the-ground efforts. Without Rotarians, we could not succeed in eradicating polio.